Women's suffrage movements. In 1897, the National Union of Women's Suffrage Societies, NUSS, was formed from various local women's suffrage societies. Their goal was to achieve for women the same voting rights as held by men. Their tactics were legal means such as peaceful demonstrations, petitions, and lobbying. They were known as suffragists, and this later gave birth to a new and more radical movement, the suffragettes. In 1903, Emmeline Pankhurst founded BUS, Women's Social and Political Union. Their motto was "Deeds, not words." The WSPU was the leading militant organization campaigning for women's suffrage in Great Britain. Law breaking, violence, and hunger strikes were the tactics used by this society. Emmeline was arrested on numerous occasions over the next few years and went on hunger strike herself, resulting in violent force feeding. In 1913, in response to the wave of hunger strikes, the government passed what became known as the Cat and Mouse Act. Hunger striking prisoners were released until they grew strong again, and then re-arrested. Things took a darker turn after Black Friday on the 18th of November 1910. One of the most important suffragette princess, Sophia Duleep Singh, daughter of Maharaja Duleep Singh, led a 400-strong demonstration to Parliament together with Mrs. Pankhurst. As suffragettes met a wall of policemen outside Parliament. Heavily outnumbered, the women were assaulted by both police and male vigilantes in the crowd. Many sustained serious injuries and two women died as a result. More than 150 suffragettes were arrested. A lot said they had been groped by the police and male bystanders, says Elizabeth Crawford, author of The Women's Suffrage Movement, a reference guide. After that, women didn't go to these demonstrations unprepared. On the 4th of June 1913, Davison attended the Epsom Derby. As the race was underway, she ran onto the track and attempted to grab the bridle of Anmer, the horse owned by King George V. The horse collided with her and she fell to the ground, where she was trampled by its hooves. Davison's purpose in attending the Derby is not clear. She had purchased a return rail ticket and a ticket to a suffragette dance later that day. It is a possibility that she entered the racetrack to attach a flag to Anmer, so that when the horse crossed the finishing line, it would be flying the WSPU flag. Davison died 4 days later in Epsom Cottage Hospital due to a fractured skull and internal injuries caused by the incident. Her funeral on the 14th of June 1913 was organized by the Women's Social and Political Union, WSPU. Thousands of suffragettes accompanied the coffin and tens of thousands of people lined the streets of London. After a service in Bloomsbury, her coffin was taken by train to the family grave in Morpeth, Northumberland. When the First World War began in August 1914, Emmeline and Christabel considered that the threat posed by Germany was a danger to all humanity, and that the British government needed the support of all citizens. They persuaded the WSPU to halt all militant suffrage activities until fighting on the European mainland ended. It was no time for dissent or agitation. Pankhurst believed that the danger posed during the First World War by what she called the German peril outweighed the need for women's suffrage. "When the time comes, we shall renew that fight," she said, "but for the present we must all do our best to fight a common foe." After the war, the Representation of the People Act of 1918 granted the vote to women over the age of 30 who met a property qualification. The same act gave the vote to all men over the age of 21. Then 1928 Act widened suffrage by giving women electoral equality with men. It gave the vote to all women over 21 years old, regardless of property ownership. Emmeline Pankhurst's dream was finally come true: freedom to vote just before her death on the 14th of June 1928.